75,000 a year goes in. But I think, hold on, hold on, hold on, I think what Judy's saying is that we are only doing Article 5, and Article 5 is reduction of last year. So when you add those other articles in, is, will that increase the budget when you hit last year?
Again, I possibly, I cannot answer that question on where they are.
Because of revenue?
Yes.
Because of revenue, uncertain revenue.
Is the operating budget total going to be 5.825 million if those more articles go through?
I assume so.
Yes.
Is the current, last year's operating budget, is it 5,730,000 with the more articles?
I'm sorry, what?
The 7.3 million, that will include what?
Should be in here.
So that's what it is in here. So the government, the operating budget of what articles from last year, that's total, subtracted from what the proposal, if all the more articles are included, is an increase of $91,000 in the operating budget.
Total budget.
Total budget.
Yeah, this is Dan Hatter, and it's Dan Graham.
It seems to me like the operating budget, nothing else, is practically the same as last year's, because what you're trying to add in, if there was roughly $100,000 more articles last year, and there's roughly $100,000 this year, you just sort of, kind of, just kind of cross those out?
Yes, and I didn't cross those out.
And the operating budget is roughly the same then, if nothing else, as it was presented last year?
So without the more articles, the operating budget for this year is 5,555,000, roughly. With, so this year, without the more articles, it's 5,730,000, roughly, an increase of $100,000, roughly.
Graham?
I think we need a semantic clarification. There are two parts to this budget. There's the operating budget, and there are warrant articles. When you take the warrant articles and the operating budget, you combine them, they're called the total budget. So you've got to stop confusing operating budget with total budget.
Right now,
They're separate things.
With the operating budget.
Just the operating budget.
Correct.
But if you look at the operating budget, in this document,
Yes.
it includes the warrant articles. For this current
For this current year, yes, so it's the total budget. And you're trying to compare that to operating budget that's proposed, which is not the same thing.
Right.
Because the operating budget that's being proposed is not the warrants.
Correct.
The operating budget for this year does.
No, that's the total budget, right?
Yeah, that's total budget.
Right, total, not operating.
But the bottom line is whatever is going on, these warrants are approved this year, it's the same thing. It goes in the same way.
Then it becomes a total budget.
But we haven't got to those other ones yet. Right now, we're just dealing with the operating budget.
Right.
Okay, any other questions? Okay, are we ready for a vote?
We have a roll call vote, please.
We have a roll call vote, yep. Which way do you want to go?
Go with Ed.
Okay.
Yes.
No. No.
Yes.
No.
Yes.
No.
Yes.
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 Six yeses.
That is? Okay. Okay, the operating budget has passed, we go forward to the deliberative session. The next one is the collective bargaining.
You're not going to vote to that horrible thing about making people vote to send it forward, or we're just going to do it?
We just did vote. Do the motion to take it to the deliberative. Yes. So Article 5 is going as presented, and on it stands 45 budget committee. Article 6, is it? The next one? It's the collective bargaining, what's your pleasure about, yes?
Motion to accept, Mr. Chair.
Seconded?
Seconded.
Okay, seconded. Open for discussion.
I'd like to pass out the
thank you for doing this, but the lines, if we continue on the plan we're on now, with a projected 5% increase, and then we continue on the lower plan with a projected 5% increase, the space between them gets increasingly larger. In other words, we will be enjoying savings as we go along. Should, and nobody can guess this, but should medical insurance rates increase by 7%, 8%, or 10%, then the space between those two lines gets even bigger. So that's something to keep in mind. It's a really good deal to have a collective bargaining unit where the medical plan is just a lower cost plan.
Bill?
Healthcare costs are one of the biggest drivers of expenses in the community. We have an opportunity here to go ahead with a less expensive plan, and I believe we ought to take it, because if we don't, our costs are going to continue to increase. So I support this, and I urge the rest of the board to support it as well.
Ed?
I've traditionally supported when I was on the record many years ago. But I'm going to vote on the school increase this year because essentially what you're showing here is you're reducing it in quite a bit. All of these years I've been feeling that we shouldn't have been on the Cadillac, we should have been on a regular one. So I applaud the school board and the teachers and others who have gone for that. So that's my rationale. One other thing, though, that I haven't heard discussion or question, is that we're showing here is that essentially the benefit to me, the taxpayer, as a result of it. But how much did the teachers really give up this much? Or if what you look at the benefits, the reduction in the benefits that the teachers are going to have, that's a function of the composition of the existing teachers. And I could just say one thing, if you had a lot of old teachers, you wouldn't have pregnancies, and if you had a lot of young people, you might. But what are they really giving up here? Is it really costing the teachers that much, this difference, the savings, or were we just paying for something that we weren't getting anyhow?
I will try to answer that. The coverage that the teachers will receive remains pretty much the same. It actually remains the same. The cost of what to provide the same coverage is lower on this plan because it is a consumer-driven health plan, and they get a health savings account that they can put into it as well. So not only is the town having this amount of savings, the teacher's part that they pay for the premium is also going down. They will also see savings in premium costs. So they are giving up nothing in coverage, and we are all gaining on the cost.
So that's a reason I think we should vote for this year, contrary to my previous position.
Thank you. Suzanne, you have that to
advantage. I was just going to say, you also brought up a question last week about the budget, that how that gets reconciled going forward.
Yes, and you had brought up the question on Wednesday about should the collective bargaining unit pass, how then does the actual budget get reconciled? And of course, we don't have an official budget until we know what has passed and what hasn't passed. So immediately following the voting day in March, our business administrator will go through, see what passed or didn't pass, and adjust the budget. So the new health amount, the health amount in the current budget will go down by this 45, will go down, and the salary level will go up.
Charlie?
Okay, in August, you came and asked us on the budget committee, what can the school do to pass this agreement? Why did it fail? And I suggested that they should cut the 5% to the step raise and ownership, because that's 5% is way too much, and they should pay more in their premiums, a percentage of their premiums. None of those, I agree with the teachers need a raise, but I don't think we should go back to every year come in 3 years, I would agree with it. As it stands this way, I'm sorry, I have to vote against it for that pencil.
Ken?
If you talk a little bit again about the 1.5% increase for the salaries, so you said it's the eighth step only, that's across all levels of education, and this puts them on the right step with that?
No, that is to help defray out-of-pocket costs that the teachers will be assuming within the plan.
So it's not adjusting the step track?
It's not adjusting the track. We wanted to make sure it was a permanent increase because the insurance change is a permanent change. So we wanted to make sure that we were permanently defraying the cost. And so we added $1,000 to step eight, period, that's it. No other steps have been affected, no. Okay.
Yes, did you have any other?
No.
Okay, but Suzanne and then Charlie.
So, I want to say that I understand all of the increase of the teachers is to cover the experience course track.
That's the bulk of the cost to the program. The 1.5% is just an increase to one experience step at the bottom.
That is correct. And I can tell you that the catch-up steps to put people on the proper experience, we have six teachers who are affected for a total of 20 years that they have not been paid for. By experience, that's 20 years of experience that we in the town have not yet paid the teachers for. And that accounts for a very, I think, close to 60,000. Right.
Okay. You talked about $1,000 or 1.5% for eighth step person. Is that included in this $63,110 for the salary increase?
It is.
That is recommended by the budget committee.
Yes.
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 Yes. Motion is passed, recommended by the budget committee. Article 8, to see if district will appropriate the sum of $75,000 in a capital improvement fund, and no amount of taxation. What is your desire on this one, Judy? I'm sorry.
So I need to accept this one article.
Okay. Okay. Open for discussion? Yes, sir.
I'd like to reduce it to $50,000. I'd like to amend it. I'll make a motion to amend it to $50,000.
I don't think they can amend it.
All right, so you're asking for, if you have a second?
Okay.
And the amendment is now open for discussion. What is the discussion on the amendment? Judy?
This warrant article will cost the town no money, and it will help us to have a fund that we can draw on in the future. This is, we're building up a savings account so that we can replace the boiler. We had an incident over the end of the holidays where one of our pumps blew, and it had to be fixed immediately. If it had been more than one of the eight, we would have been looking at a $400,000 expense. I think it is only prudent to have money in the savings account. It's the way the town does CIP. I see no reason to decrease this at all, since it has no impact on taxation.
Thank you, gentlemen. Then Suzanne.
Well, as Ed had pointed out before, it is taxpayer money. It's just coming out of whatever.
Right. Yes. All right.
With that said, though, my view is let's keep it where it is, because if it goes into this warrant article, then this is subject to a vote by the town to be used, correct? So
that is correct.
Any money that gets put into this has to come back to the voters in order to be expended. If only $50,000 goes into this, if there's more than $50,000, where does that money go? So if we put it here, we know where it's going. I just assume leave it in here at that higher amount.
Well, I'll keep it in
there. Sure. Please do.
But it is common usage to describe a warrant article that has no impact on taxation as such. I realize that it's our money. But the tax, what that says is, it's the money is coming from any surplus in the budget. Any surplus in that budget, if we decided not to do anything, doesn't affect the tax rate, right? So this just gives us the opportunity, if the school district can save that money, to put it in a fund that can be used in the future. And rather than, you know, sitting in fund balance, which is nice, but it just doesn't have an impact on this year's, on the tax rate associated with this year's budget.
All right, that's what I wanted to get clarified. I'm going to ask the question, because it does affect the tax rate for next year if there's surplus that is used against taxes.
Not necessarily. No. Not necessarily. The school, the
also entitled to hold a certain percentage for a year.
Yeah, that's the sentence, yeah.
Yes, and actually, this year, we chose not to hold that entire percentage, so we could return more to the town to help defray, because it was such an unusual year with the assessment being done, we wanted to make sure we returned as much as possible. So we did not keep the full 2.5%, we chose to keep less.
Right.
So that we now have less in our emergency fund.
But not just the school, but any budget in the town office, the bottom line authority has the right to do that.
Correct.
Okay.
But you already held $113,000 from last year's budget. That was what was supposed to be turned over to the town. So it's not really that you gave 120 out of the closing budget. All right, so you're going to change your vote to no. Okay, Charlie?
No.
motion has been failed. So we're back to the motion to put aside the sum of $75,000. Any further discussion on that?
Could I make my motion to increase to $150,000?
Would you like to make an amendment to increase it to $150,000? As long as there's $150,000, it's whatever is available.
Yeah.
Is there a second on that? One second? So now it's back to $75,000. Any further discussion? Let's have a roll call vote. Ed?
Yes.
implications and so forth, so I'm going to know.
articles were approved, what effect does that on the tax rate?
If all three articles are approved?
Correct.
If all three articles are approved, it affects the tax rate as a plus 0.21. So 21 cents.
Can you give a breakdown of the articles and the taxes?
I believe it's more than that.
We're not talking about representatives.
I believe it's 44 cents.
No.
Well, we will have Judy have, get on page and send us something writing how it impacts the taxes, okay? Before.
Do you have this on?
I haven't written it.
$122,044.
But you are taking revenue.
I'm taking these three articles. What effect does that have on the tax?
All right, so the budget is essentially down from last year.
I'm talking these three.
No, I asked about that.
Oh, I'm sorry. It's 39 plus 93. So there's no money raised for taxation what? For the 75.
No, it's three of that.
Yeah, so operating budget, collective bargaining agreement.
No, collective bargaining agreement, article.
You're talking about
seven, article 6, 7, and 9. What effect is that?
Okay, there is $1 in article 9.
Yep.
What